the next presenter. Again, this is going to be a three-minute video. We are going to have a short video on food losses, their causes, and strategies for their reduction.
Fruits and vegetables are important constituents of healthy diets. They are, however, highly perishable, and if not properly handled, they undergo rapid spoilage, resulting in food loss. On an average, about one-third of the food produced for human consumption is lost or wasted globally. This is about 1.3 billion tons per year, valued at nearly $1 trillion. Post-harvest losses in fruits and vegetables occur between harvest and the market are the result of inappropriate harvest, poor handling, and poor bulk packaging practices. Poor bulk packaging practice is a weak point in fruit and vegetable supply chains in Bangladesh. It results in large quantities of tomatoes being damaged during transportation. These tomatoes that were intended for human consumption will never make it to the mouth of the consumer. They will end up as post-harvest loss. Post-harvest losses not only represent the tomatoes that we must throw away, but they also represent the loss sustained at the farm level. We need to factor the cost of inputs, seeds, fertilizer, land, labor, water resource and energy used in producing the tomatoes, in harvesting them, and in taking them to the market. All of these inputs and resources are thrown away with the tomatoes. Through its Technical Cooperation Program, Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations has equipped tomato farmers with knowledge to better manage quality and reduce the level of losses in tomato supply chain. Farmers were trained on good harvest practices, proper handling of tomatoes in order to avoid mechanical damage and contamination, sorting to remove defective and damaged tomatoes, washing, drying, packaging in plastic crates instead of red mesh plastic bags for transportation to the market. By applying these practices, the level of losses in tomatoes will be reduced dramatically and good quality tomatoes will be available at the market.
আগে যখন টমেটো কিনতাম 1 কেজির মধ্যে অর্ধেকই নরম থাকতো দেখা যেত তরকারিতে দিলে তরকারি ভালো হতো না বা প্রিজার্ভও করা যেত না কিন্তু ইদানিং যখন বাজারে টমেটো কিনতে আসছি খুবই সতেজ আর টাটকা টমেটো পাচ্ছি
আমরা আশাবাদী এই প্রকল্পটির মাধ্যমে কৃষক তথা এই সাপ্লাই চেইনের যে স্টেকহোল্ডাররা আছে এদের মধ্যে এই সংগ্রহোত্তর অপচয় কমানোর ব্যাপারে একটি সচেতনতা সৃষ্টি হয়েছে
But it's also important that everybody has to make something out of this. If one person is making and the other is not, then it won't work. So we have to see that the farmer gets some, the merchant gets some, the retailer gets some, and the consumer also gets a benefit.
Good post-harvest handling practices will not only make available more fruits and vegetables, but it will contribute to improve the shelf life and quality of fruits and vegetables available in the local market. It will also allow us to make better use of our limited natural resources.
Thank you all very much. Thank you, Your Excellency. Thank you very much. And we are happy that we are delivering to make you happy. Great. So I think we now open the floor for questions. I'm sure people will have questions. The floor is opened. We've all seen what the course is like, and I hope that we'll take some time to go through and see what this course is about. And hopefully also, Petrina, maybe we can look at actually getting this into universities. Some universities are developing curriculum and they would like to probably take up some of these courses. We have to be actually proactive in getting this in. And possibly maybe we can form an FAO academy. You take a number of courses and you get a certificate. Why not? FAO certificate or RBA certificate. When you take 10 courses, we give you a certificate. Anyway, let's think about it. Okay, so the floor is open.
Okay. This e-learning course. So I have an experience with Morocco. I have participated as a co-facilitator for this FLA methodology. There is RNE, 9 country people, especially for post-harvest experts, university professors who has come from different countries. So it's very interesting, and they appreciated this e-learning course. Many of the people have completed this course and give the good feedback. But in some cases, I thought that many of the people are actually, they have not, we have instructed, requested that before coming to the workshop, training workshop, you please complete this course. But actually, many of the people has not done this. So indeed, in such cases, what I am thinking that if there is any certification system like security clearance, security certificate, ASTI, F certificate, this type of certificate, if possible, we can give the, you will take 2-3 days for this relearning course and finish this one and get the certificate and then attend the course. By this way, I think it would be more fruitful. So this is my suggestion, if further possible for this type of work. And I hope this will be utilized because of many projects or baseline analysis or any valuation project. Every project has included now the post-harvest loss reduction steps, because post-harvest loss reduction is a monitoring indicator in many projects because of too much circulation of this slogan that 1/3 of food is lost every year. So it will be used, I hope, beyond FAO project. In different kinds of projects are there. Everybody is aware now food loss is a problem. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yes, any other comment on this? Yes, sure.
Thank you very much for this question, because it gives me the opportunity to say that we are actually working on certification. We will be associating to the course in early 2019. It will be available. It will be a certification which is called an online digital badge. I don't know if you are aware of it. And this becomes basically an internationally recognized certificate, not for having completed the course, but for having acquired specific competences. So that there will be a test that will be added. Every time the learner basically performs well in the test, they get this digital badge, which then can be added to your LinkedIn, to your e-portfolio, to your CV, and it becomes part of your professional profile because it certifies the acquisition of competences. And so we're working on that. Yes, and actually, I went very fast in my presentation. I mentioned other methods, and in fact, you're right. It is very useful to actually, before a workshop, to ask participants to do the course online before coming. But this has to be followed by a test. So you need to first perform well at the test, and then you can come to the face-to-face, basically. So you need to have your digital badge, and then you can come to the... So, thank you.
Thank you.